purpose is for the primary students, and I will teach my students how to use the abacus to add and also to subtract. For abacus to, students should know place of numbers, and for place of numbers, Castro has already taught it on his channel. Thus, I taught my students how to identify ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, and many more. So this is how an abacus looks like. We have some rings. This is how an abacus looks like. So you can use the abacus to count. Now, let's count this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me add another ring. 6. So you see, we are having 5, 6. And this 5, 6, we have here as ones, and this one as tens. We know that the tens, once we turn this, this 5, the place for 5 is what? Tens. And the place value, we have it at 50. So 50 plus this one, so we'll get what? 56. So take note that we will deal with hundreds, tens, ones, thousands, tens of thousands, and hundreds of thousands. So you can also be given something like this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So let's count. 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we have this as ones, tens, hundred, and thousand. So always you label it like this. So I'm coming to show my students how to use abacus to add. How to use abacus to add. If I give my students add 2 and 3 using the abacus, I know 2 plus 3 is 5. We all know 2 plus 3 is 5. But how can we use the abacus to add? How can we use it to what? Add. So now 2. You draw your 2 rings on this. On this bar. So this is 2. We have 3. So 3. These numbers is ones. This is ones, and this is also ones. So ones. So you count. You draw another bar like this. Now let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you draw all the rings on this bar. 1, 2. You count. Plus, this plus, you write the mathematical symbol for it. 1, 2, 3. We are now counting. Let's count this 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you see, I represented all these rings on one bar because we are having only ones here. We are having only ones. So 2 plus 3 using our abacus is what? 5. Let's take the second example. Add 3, 4. And 1, 3 using the abacus. So this is how you add it. So I have one abacus here plus another abacus. So how many? 3, 1, 2, 3. This is what? 4. I draw it. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you see, this is ones and this is tens. This is ones, this is tens. That's why I said we will deal with place of numbers. How to identify your ones, tens. So your abacus to, you will identify your ones and tens, hundreds, and so forth. So this is ones and this is tens. This is ones and this is tens. So now we are having what here? one. The second one is what? One, two, three. What you do? This is what you do. You see now, we are having tens and ones. So you draw your two sticks like this. You can't add tens to ones. Please take note. You cannot count tens with ones on this abacus. So you will count your tens to tens and ones to ones. So now, how many tens? We have one, two, three, four. So I'll draw it here. One, two, three, four. What is our second one? It's what? Ones. So we add ones to ones. When we are arranging, you can't add ones to tens. So we have one, two, three, four. This one, two, five, six, seven. So we draw seven here. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. So let's count. One, two, three. So one, two, three, four. Half one plus. You change this one to the mathematical symbol. We have one here. One, two, three. Equal to, let's count. One, two, three, four. So this is the total. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So this is seven. So always take note that if you are adding it up, if you are adding it up, you cannot add tens to ones. Take note. You cannot add tens to ones. We add tens to tens and you will arrange it nicely like this. You see, our tens, we have one, two, three for the first abacus. The second one, we have how many tens? One. So three plus one is what? Four. You arrange it nicely here. You cannot add this three to this three. No. You cannot add this three to this three. It's not accepted when we are dealing with abacus. Let's take these examples. Let's take these examples to illustrate how we are using an abacus. Question one. We are now coming to add the following using an abacus. One, 24 and 35. 24 and 35. So this means you draw your abacus nicely. Plus, because we are having ones and tens. If we have 100, this means we will draw another line. So we have how many here? Two. So one, two. What is our ones? Four. One, two, three, four. So this is ones, this is tens. Plus 3, 5. How many tens? Our tens is what? One, two, three. How many ones? One, two, three, four, five. So equals. So now, you see, we have our ones, and here two is tens. How many tens here? We have two. And how many tens here? Three. So you count one, two, three, four, five. You draw it nicely here. Two, three, four, five. How many ones? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. You see, I didn't add the tens to the ones. No. Take note. Always, if you are arranging it on an abacus, we add the tens to tens and arrange it nicely here. So take note. Let's take note. Now, we have one, two here, so two. We are having four here. Plus one, two, three. So we have three here. One, two, three, four, five. So five equals one, two, three, four, 5. So 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you see, it's not difficult. Abacus is not difficult. If you want to have using Abacus, this is how it is being done. So always don't add your tens to ones. This ones. No, we add tens to tens and ones to ones. Ones. Take note. So we have 3, 3, 3 and 2, 4, 1. So this is how our abacus will look like. Plus. Equals 1, 2, 3. So we have ones, tens, hundred, ones, tens, hundred. So how many hundred for this value? We have 300. So 1, 2, 3. How many tens? 1, 2, 3. So we have 3 for each. How many hundreds? So we have 1, 2. How many tens? We have 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many ones? It's what? 1. So this is ones, tens, hundreds. Ones, tens, hundred. You identify it nicely. So now, let's count it. We have ones, tens, hundred. So you add your hundred to hundred. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are reading the total rings here. 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is our total rings for tens? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you draw your 7 rings here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What is our total rings for ones? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let us write our mathematical value. So we have 3 here, 3 here, 3 here, plus we have 2 here, 4 here, 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 4 here. This is question 2. It's not difficult. It is not difficult once you follow what Castro is doing. Question 3. So you identify the place for this number. So we have ones, tens, hundred, and thousand. Ones, tens, hundred, and thousand. Once you identify this, it becomes simple. So this is how our abacus will look like. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 plus. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's not difficult. If this one was two numbers, you get it on your 2 lines. Equals. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have ones, tens, hundred, thousand. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand. So you see, you draw it nicely like this. It's not difficult. So let's take the first number. So we have only one value here. So 1, 1,000, we have 1, 1,000 columns. So hundreds, we have 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Tens, we have 3. 1, 2, 3. Ones, we have 1, 2. That's why I showed you how to represent numbers on an abacus. The second one, we have 2,000. So 2. 100 is 1. Tens is 1. And ones, we have 6. So what is the total range for 1,000? We have 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. What is the total range for 100? The first ring, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7. So you draw 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
This is the total range for tens. We have
1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4.
The total range for ones.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Once we know this, we write our values. So plus equal to this. So what is this? 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 3 here and 2. So we have 2 here, 1, 1, and 6. Let's count. We want to know the total. 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 7. So this is 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have this question to us 8. So you see, I've taught you how to use abacus to add. We are now moving on to our last question. We have the last question. So this is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, and tens of thousand. So this is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, and tens of thousand. So we are coming to add using an abacus. So we will have 5 left. 3, 4, 5 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, and 10s of 1000. So ones, tens, hundred, thousand, tens of thousand. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, tens of thousand. So now we are having 5 things. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's our 5. 2, 1, 2, 3. We have 1, 2. So you see, I'm drawing my first abacus. This 1, 2, I'm having 3, 1, 2, 3, and the 1s is 1. In the second number, we have the tens of thousands, we have 3. Our 1000, we have 2, 1, 2, and our 100 is 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. The tens is 1. And 1, 2 is 1. So now let's add it. 1000, we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You see, I've made it simple. It's not difficult when using abacus to add, but students always find this difficult. Now let's count our rings on 1000. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 100, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we draw 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Tens, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Ones, we have 1, 2. So 1, 2. Let's write our values. So we are having 5 here, 1, 2, we have 3 here, 1, 2, 3, you just count, 1, so we have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, this one is 4, 1, 1, it's the same as these numbers. If you get confused, you just write the same numbers here. So let's count the total, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have 18. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is 7. So we have 4 here. And here too, we are having 2. So you see, I've used my abacus to add it nicely. Our next session, I will teach you how to use abacus to subtract. I believe, my noble students, you have really enjoyed this lesson on how to use an abacus to add. Thank you and have a nice day.